All right, we'd like to welcome Rolex number two, Suzann Pettersen, into the interview room. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
And congratulations on your win last week. Can you just talk first off just about the emotions of that day and shooting 64 in the final round and not really kind of expecting anything? And
yeah, well, it was just one of those days where everything went my way. I went out in the morning, didn't really feel like I had a chance, and got to play my own game. I never really kind of felt that pressure until I was on 17 when I realized I actually was somewhere close to the leaders, knowing that the leaders still had almost an entire back nine to play, and had to sit and wait for like over 2 hours to see what they were doing, and realized it would come down to the last hole if I was going to get into a playoff or not. And I was fortunate enough to kind of have my side of the luck this time, and it was, like I said, a little bit unexpected, but I must say it was awfully nice to win that way too, to come from back.
Before the Sybase match play earlier this year, it had been about 20 months since you had won, and now you have three wins, two LPGA Tour wins, and then the win at the Ladies Irish Open. How nice is it to get back in the winning circle and be able to put a string of these wins together?
Well, it's always nice. I mean, I think everyone kept asking me, when are you going to win again? You keep finishing seconds. And for me, it's obviously it's also about winning tournaments, but it's also if you're there every week in contention and kind of putting yourself in the right position, hopefully at one day you'll be able to close it off. And sometimes the margin is on your side, other times you can play great and other people outplay you on the Sunday. This time I was lucky enough that no one kind of ran away with it early on Sunday, and I've kind of been a part of all kind of different scenarios where you've been so far ahead and someone's been shooting like 10 under on you and you lose by one, and then finally I had the other reverse one and I could kind of catch them. So it's nice to be in the winner's circle. It's all about, it gives you a lot of confidence. It definitely helps when I putt well, which is what I've been spending a lot of time on over the last 3 or 4 months. Just overall putting better, so I feel like I have a chance when it comes down to the back nine.
In addition to all the wins this summer, it's been an emotional summer for you with everything that happened in Norway. Can you just talk a little bit about how the summer has been in terms of that tragedy?
No, it's been an awful summer for us back home. It's been, I mean, the one incident, 21st of July or 22nd of July, was probably the worst day in Norway's history since the Second World War. So many young people who got killed and lost their lives, and it's terrible. And then there's been a few personal tragic stories as well, so it's been a very brutal summer, but it's sad to say, but it helps you realize what you have in life and appreciate what you do, and for me it's been helping me to just relax more on the golf course and just enjoy what I do. So hopefully we can all move forward, and I'm pretty proud of how the nation has just kind of all come together as one unit and stuck together.
Questions for Suzann?
Just curious to know, in terms of your just your opinion to, you know, win back to back, you know, coming off a win last week. You know, I know you have the mindset, like you said, you're much more it gives you a lot of confidence, but it's so tough to win consecutive weeks, isn't it?
Well, I just think out here it's so hard to win anyway. The level of golf being played is so good, and the depth is probably better than it's ever been. I think it's rare to see people win multiple times in a season now. And you're lucky if you win once, and it's even better if you win several times. So, like I said, you don't take anything for granted out here, and you just got to try and enjoy those moments when you finally pull it off, because it's getting really tough out here, and there's so many good golfers.
Do you feel this golf course suit your style? Is a good course here for you?
I hope it's gonna rain, so it's gonna play a little bit longer, because you get no roll on the driver, and it kind of sets you in a position where you have a lot of longer irons into the greens. The rough, I thought yesterday, was not so penalizing. Today it was brutal. So I don't know what they've done overnight. So if you miss fairways there, it's going to be a tough course. But it's pretty much what you see, what you get. It's right in front of you. And I think you'll see some low scores around here.
Does being or does getting to number one in the world matter to you? And if that's a goal for you, what's it going to take for you to catch Yanni Tseng?
It's always been a dream of mine since I was a kid to become the best player in the world. So yes, it would mean a lot to me. What it takes to kind of catch Yanni, win tournaments. Go out and win tournaments and try to win as many as you can, because she's going to win her fair share during a year. And during the time I've been on tour, we've had three number ones. Annika was a phenomenal number one. She kind of set that standard back then, what is that now, 5-6 years ago. And then Lorena kind of took over that and took it to another level. And now Yanni's kind of, again, stepped away and kind of tried to distance herself from the rest of us. So it just makes the rest of us work even harder. And like I said, you really appreciate when you do well. And when you don't do well, you just dig in and you work even harder.
Any more questions for Suzann?
Maybe I can venture one. You mentioned something about you're lucky if you win. There was I think it's Gary Player who once said, the better I get, the luckier I seem to be. How much luck do you think, notwithstanding the fact that you have to be a great player, but how much luck plays in winning a tournament in terms of the rolling of the ball and so on?
No, I mean, it's like marginal. I mean, sometimes you can, every putt you look at goes in the next day, every putt hits the lip and it goes, I mean, you miss the hole. So, I mean, it's so marginal. And I think the more you practice, the luckier you get. So I think it kind of goes hand in hand. But at the end of the day, you want to try and eliminate those margins in your favor. Sometimes that happens, sometimes it doesn't. And the golf gods, sometimes they're brutal and sometimes they're nice. So I don't think it's kind of out of your control as well.
Well, when you win a tournament, you can always look back and say, geez, if I hadn't made that... dumped it into the cup from the sand trap, I wouldn't have won. You know, and what's like?
What could have been? You can always look back and say what could have been. But sometimes it's nice to look back and say, God, what a great bounce that was coming off the trees, or something that went in your favor. And at the end of the day, you actually won the golf tournament. I think it evens out as you play.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Okay.